Your health is your greatest asset. In fact, your health, your wellness is king. And just like the king is the most important piece on the chessboard, when the king is off, everything is over. If you lose your health, you have lost everything. In this video, I'll be sharing with you what you need to do if you want to live healthy for the rest of your life. Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Majid Worola, a wellness and smart income coach. And if you are new to this channel, remember to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification button so that you do not miss out on life-saving information I'll be dropping every Tuesday, 9:45 p.m. Now, let's get in. We're going to start firstly with what you must stay away from if you want to live healthy for the rest of your life. So we're going to start with the don'ts. Number one, don't be physically inactive. Physical inactivity is a serious factor that affects health more than anybody could ever imagine. Particularly as you grow older, physical inactivity. Number two, if you smoke, quit smoking, stop smoking. Number three, stop the use of alcohol. Stop the use of alcohol. Number four, stop taking unbalanced diet. That is junk. Stop doing that. I'll be giving your body the best chance to keep you healthy. And number five, stop relying on drugs. Stop relying on drugs that if anything happens, you know the best drug to take, or the best drug will be prescribed to you. Stop depending on drugs. Focus more on staying healthy and not depending on drug, because drug is at the point of emergency when you need to do things, of course, but then it comes with a whole lot of side effects. What do you need to do if you plan to stay healthy for the rest of your life? One, be physically active. Exercise your body 30 minutes at least 5 times in a week. And the recommendation from health authority is for you to have taken 10,000 steps on daily basis. That's the recommendation. That will keep you away from disease, keep you away from sickness, now and even in the future. People that are active live a healthier, longer life than those that are not active. You might not get to 10,000 at the beginning, but have it at the back of your mind, that is a goal. So you can, and it's good to have this tracker, pedometer to have it, and then you can track, okay, I'm on 2,000, what can I do? Let me take every additional step actually count towards your wellness, towards your health, towards your living a long, healthy life. So exercise and track it. Number two, find time to rest. Find a way to break your stress circle. We all go through one stress or the other, but you must find a way to break this stress circle, because if you don't, and the stress circle continuously gets completed, it will cause more havoc than you could actually ever imagine. Break your stress circle. Manage your stress. Number three, fix your diet. Fix your diet. Today, in the modern world and with modern processes and everything, we are actually eating upside down. We are taking too much of what our body does not need much of, like the fat and carbohydrates and protein, particularly as we grow older. And we are taking very little of what our body needs the most, which is fruits and vegetables, which help our immune system and a whole lot of things in the body system. And we need a lot of whole grains, which form the foundation of a healthy living for any person, wherever you live in the world. And finally, we need huge physical activity, if there's anything called that, to actually maintain a healthy life. But what are we doing today? That's what we are doing today. What do we need to do? We actually need to take very little of anything fat and carbohydrates. Then we'll take a little bit more protein. Then we'll take a whole lot more of fresh fruits and vegetables. Not the processed, not the one planted with chemicals and stuffs. No, not the GMO, no. And then we need a whole lot of whole grains in our diet. And then with adequate physical activity, our body would have been positioned in a way by which it can keep you and I healthy for the rest of our life. Doing this will actually ensure that you live healthy, you save a lot of unplanned medical expenses that comes up with being careless with health, and without any assurance of recovery, you're going to save yourself a lot of money. You are going to save yourself from losing money, because if you are not feeling well, if you are not fine, you will lose money because your business will suffer it one way or the other. So you have everything to gain to do what you need to do to stay healthy than to do what you're not supposed to do and actually lose your health in the process. Your health remains your greatest asset. Your health in life is the king in the field of play. And if you lose your health, you lost everything. You can lose money and get it, make it back. But if you lose your health, which can lead to losing your life, is one life. So ensure you treat your health as a king, as the king it is all the time, not just by saying health is wealth, but actually taking some more action in the right direction, treating it as a king, and then you'll be able to enjoy a healthy life for the rest of your life. And remember, as long as your king is there, all other players, all other pieces on the chessboard is actually meaningful. Without the king, the rest is meaningful. Protect your health today and enjoy a healthy life for the rest of your life. Remember to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification button so that you don't miss out on this kind of amazing life-saving information that drop every Tuesday, 9:45 p.m. I will see you in the next episode, where I'll be taking a deeper dive on what you need to do to maintain a healthy life for the rest of your life. Thank you.